My heart is shaking.
Mary Ben Alicia has been praying for quiet after living for weeks with a mother's greatest fear, the thought of something terrible happening to her four children. The thoughts come with the sounds of rockets that fly overhead here so often. Israel has installed an Iron Dome missile defense system near her neighborhood, a few kilometers from the Gaza border.
How many times have you taken cover?
All days. All day. All day we have boom in the air. The children is scared.
Even with the Iron Dome nearby, she says everyone here knows it doesn't work 100% of the time. And they have seen the consequences of a rocket attack. A neighborhood boy just made it home after 3 weeks in the hospital when a rocket exploded nearby. After weeks inside, she takes a chance and lets her children out to play. As the first ceasefire of the day was announced, we traveled closer to the border. Troop movements and tanks stir up dust. There was quiet here for a time.
There's no noise now. I can't even hear a drone, which is very unusual.
We arrive at Kibbutz Nirim. Gaza is just a short walk away. Adele Raymer has lived here since the 1970s. She says this is the worst fighting she has ever seen.
I mean, the past few weeks, we have artillery and cannons on both sides of the kibbutz behind. I don't know where they are, but they make a racket. It's deafening.
And yet she stays, taking us on a tour of rocket-pock streets, showing us the unexploded rocket close to the playground. And lastly, a look at the spot where her 77-year-old neighbor was severely injured when a rocket got to him before he got to safety. This kibbutz is so close to the border, the Iron Dome can't work fast enough. Most residents here have left. Adele relies on her shelter.
I've been sleeping in here since the end of June.
Few sleep well on the border now. Both Adele and Mary recognize that is especially true if you are on the Gaza side.
Does it disturb you what you're seeing happening in Gaza with all the children and mothers killed there?
Of course. I think it's a disaster what happened there, and it's a disaster what happened here.
A disaster these two mothers fear will happen again and again. The desire for revenge too great for either side to completely overcome. Sara-Sidner, CNN, on the Israel-Gaza border.